Hello and welcome back to the Road to Episode 9, my ongoing series where I chart the road to the release of Star Wars Episode 9, The Rise of Skywalker, which was about 3 hours ago. So there's so many things I wanted to film in the past week in the build-up to it, but I just didn't have the time. So here we are, and we're talking about The Rise of Skywalker very quickly. Me and Connie saw it just about 3 hours ago. It started, we saw the trilogy marathon, so we're very tired. It was very hot in that room.
It's a long time in the cinema.
Yeah.
As long as I've ever been in the cinema.
Yeah.
One go.
But it was actually the first time me and Connie saw an episode of Star Wars together for the first time, so that was really exciting, even though you're about to, for the first time on premiere, you know, midnight stuff. So, first thoughts, first reactions very quickly. I was very anxious about this because the reaction online has been very mixed, and I had read some things that happened. I was like, don't know about that. And I loved it. Yep, I'm that guy who just loves all of them.
I agree. I didn't know what to think. And surprise after surprise came, and some things that I was... My voice is going. Some things that I wasn't like shocked about, but more like, okay, yeah, and stuff like that. And some tears and some jaw-dropping moments.
Where did you get tears? Shit, we're spoiler free. Okay, so.
Oh my god.
You'll never guess it, right?
You'll see it.
Yeah.
You'll know. There was a couple of them.
Yeah.
But one major.
Oh, another one, yeah, okay.
Entertaining, that even after 12 o'clock I stayed awake. One scene where I was kind of like, what year is it? I usually go to bed between 10 and 11, and now it's almost 3 a.m. and I got to get up in 3.5 hours to travel for 16 hours back home to Norway.
It's going to be a lonely Christmas for Luke.
For you.
So was it a satisfying conclusion to
yes.
As viewed with all three movies in a row?
I think I want to see it again when I get back.
Now that you know what happens and everything. Because there are things that happen, I think, which are a lot to take in. Because there's twists and turns. Some people have said that they... And the cats are clawing at the carpet. So that was it. That was the end of the Skywalker saga and story. And I loved it. I was very satisfied. Not perfect, you know, I don't think it's as good as The Last Jedi, of course, but, you know, just lots of...
You're not going to have everything satisfied,
No, that's the thing.
There are some things where I was thinking, I wish it would have happened differently, or...
Yeah.
Or maybe that wouldn't have happened at all.
There's one thing I knew wasn't going to happen, and I was gutted about it. I thought, how the fuck can you not do that, given what happened in The Last Jedi? But having seen the film, I thought, yeah, okay, that didn't need to happen, so I was, you know... I was happy to be surprised by things.
You to tell me what that is afterwards.
Yeah, yeah. So anyway, so that we'll just wrap this up. We just saw The Rise of Skywalker, Episode 9. It's crazy. When I was a kid, like, the sequel trilogy just seemed like this mythic thing that would never happen. And here we are, and we've just seen the whole sequel trilogy. So there we go.
9.
Any final...
Actually, 11.
Oh, yeah.
And we got The Mandalorian.
Yeah. Any final thoughts?
Loved it. Yep. I just loved it.
I'm glad you loved it. Okay.
It didn't feel long at all, even though it was super late.
It's very pacey, adventure, lots of stuff going on. So
yeah, but I mean, definitely liked it better than Force Awakens.
Yeah, oh, that's cool.
But I don't know, Last Jedi, I have to watch it again.
Yeah,
because right now, I'm so like,
Awesome, you got to take it all in, yeah.
So right now, it's like at the top, but I don't think it will be once I've seen it a couple of times.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
It might be about the same.
All right, so leave it there. That's the quick reaction. Thanks for watching. And I'll get back to you soon with a lot more thoughts, of course.
Hell picture is a bird of business. You got a permit for that, sir?
No, at all.
That's a little rebellious.